me out, folks.
Ladies and gentlemen, before the national anthem, I'll give you a real quick talk about that. During the War of 1812, Francis Scott Key was assigned to go to a British ship, a British man of war that was holding American prisoners, and exchange American prisoners for British sick prisoners that the United States was holding. When he got there, the Admiral told him, "Certainly we can talk about it, but it's pretty new. Look on the horizon, you see all those black dots? That's the entire British ship coming here. The entire British fleet is coming here, and we're going to fire on Fort Henry." He says, "All they have to do is lower that flag that you all find so precious. That's all you have to do. That means you capitulate. You surrender, and you lose the war." Francis Scott Key said they will never do that. Besides that, that fort is mostly for supplies and women and children. He said, "Fine. All they have to do is drop that flag from the rampart and we'll stop firing." 2 hours later, the entire British fleet was there. They opened fire on Fort McHenry and they kept firing at it for the entire night. At 6 o'clock in the morning, Francis Scott Key went up from below. He was talking to the...
As your phone's getting on. Okay, somebody's real close to it with a bomb. It's okay.
Francis Scott Key went up and the Admiral told him, "I do not know why that flag is still flying. We have now asked the entire fleet to fire at the rampart where that flag is firing." The entire British fleet opened fire on that rampart. They hit it time after time after time. At 7 o'clock in the morning, the firing stopped. Francis Scott Key had been relayed to the men below what was occurring. And every time he went down, he said, they would say, "Is the flag still flying?" They'd say yes, and they'd cheer. At 7 o'clock, he got into a boat and went to the shore. He ran all the way to Fort McHenry and climbed up to find out why that flag was flying at such a precarious angle. It hadn't fallen, it was still there. When he got up there, he found out why. The British had hit it and knocked it off the rampart. It was just sitting there. But what kept that flag flying was American patriots. They were holding the flag, and every time one of them got killed because a bomb bursted near them, or a bomb exploded there, or a rocket exploded there, other American patriots took the place and held that flag, kept it flying. Freedom is never free. When you hear the Star Spangled Banner, our national anthem, you now know the story behind that and why Francis Scott Key wrote it. Americans died holding that flag up, refusing to capitulate to the British. That's why we still have the United States of America, because of patriots like that. Here's the Star Spangled Banner.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
And the rockets rain glare, the bombs burn.